Can you hear me?
Yes. Can you hear me?
No. Maybe a little.
Okay. Can you hear me?
No.
No?
Shit.
It's okay. We've had problems Hello? Can you hear me yet?
No.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
No, I can't.
Can you hear me?
Hello? Oh, there we go.
Here we go. I was wondering, yeah.
That's why.
Yeah.
All right.
I just know that because Bob and I always have to mess with that one, too, whenever we get started. So, but yeah.
I think for the most part, we're in the gold.
Yes.
Which is good.
Yes.
I always hate running into trouble.
It'll happen.
Oh, yeah, especially in this business. Yes. You want your drink?
Yes, please. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay. So, put that there. So, am I one or two?
You're one.
I'm one.
Here, it's on top of the headset.
Okay. Oh, okay. I didn't even look. So, alrighty.
Thank you. bed and I breach it. Go jam and I blow, I ain't missing. I'm dropping hit after hit, I'm just chilling. But I tell it before I do, my shit is bigger than business, it's bigger than office. I'm trying to sell me a sweat and I call up, they call for my artist. They making me offers, I don't even mind it. I'm starting from the bottom, I lost a Ferrari, Las Vegas, Nevada. I woke up the following day and went harder. I'm cracking my shit, now they see that I'm smarter. I gotta get money, I love to get harder. I gave them four burgers and one for a dollar. I can't let them down, walk around with my garter. I'm screaming, I YOLO, yeah, that's still a model. I know I'm yoga. Thank you, daughter. I got sins on my mind, and from him, got a lot of M's on my mind, and my friends.
Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Test, test, testing 1, 2, 3. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Test, test. Hello, hello. Awesome. Hello, hello. Awesome. How now, brown cow? You got to pump it up. Don't you know you pump it up? You got to pump it up. Don't you know you pump it up? Hello, hello. How are you all doing this evening? Hello, hello. And welcome everyone here to Southwest Park, where it's the Frontier Bobcats hosting the Southwestern Illinois College Blue Storm. I'm joined with Tammy Anderson. Tammy, how are you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you doing, Anthony?
Alec.
Alec, sorry.
No, that's okay. I'm doing good. Ready to get underway here.
Good.
Yeah, it looks like we're about ready to start the national anthem here. So tell you what, we'll take a quick minute break. You're watching FCC Softball powered by RJ Marketing.
Let Black's Flowers and Gifts in downtown Fairfield make someone smile with some flower therapy. Whether they deserve a high five or need to feel better, a beautiful fresh floral arrangement from Black's will fit the bill. Also, check out Black's for that perfect gift. They carry home decor, locally made jewelry, soaps and candles, candy and snack baskets, and balloon bouquets. For flower therapy or gifts for any occasion, see Black's Flowers and Gifts at 310 East Main in Fairfield or call 618-847-7076.
Are you a small business owner? Say goodbye to bookkeeping headaches. At F&B Financial Tax and Consulting, our top-notch accounting services will keep your finances in order, allowing you to focus on what you do best, growing your business. With F&B Financial, you're not just a client, you're family. Contact us at 618-842-2183 or visit us online at fnbcommunitybank.com. Experience peace of mind with our expert support. It's a beautiful day in Fairfield, isn't it? Introducing a new weekly podcast on Friday mornings at 8:30 a.m. on YouTube. It's a beautiful day in Fairfield. Featuring local events and news, special guests, birthdays, anniversaries, trivia, and more. Follow us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel at RJ on the Air.
And welcome back. We're warming up here.
Yeah, Bobcats are getting warmed up out there. We've got number 9, Carly Bean, pitching for the Bobcats in a 2-game series for today. Just a little getting the lineup wrote down here. At least the sun came out today.
Yeah, it's been a rainy week this week.
Oh, very rainy. Actually, I don't know about here in Fairfield, but at home in Jeff, it rained this morning. Just come down a big old downpour.
Yeah, it lingered a little bit at my house, too. I was wondering if we'd even have a game.
I know. But at least the sun came out, and the field looks pretty decent. Looks a little damp over on the first base side, but that sun out and the wind's blowing pretty good, so that should dry it out a little bit today.
All right, up to bat for the Blue Storm, we have Emily Rupert. It doesn't matter.
No, you're fine. Too. All right. We got strike one. Emily Rupert is playing center field today for Swick. Swing and strike two. Catching for the Bobcats this afternoon is number 23, Abby Cunningham. Got a 2-ball, 2-strike count. And a swinging strike three. It's a strikeout for Carly. That's a good start for today.
Absolutely.
turn down that back feed a little bit. That wind's picking up some, and it's
catching
the mic, so sounds like we're breathing hard in here, but it's just the wind picking up on us.
I hate wind.
All right, we've got strike two. Number 15, Anna Cox, is up to bat. She is the DP for Southwestern today. We got ball outside. And there's a swing and a fly ball into the right center field. Right fielder's got it. She's got it thrown in for a stand-up double for Anna. All right, up to bat for Swick is number 24, Maddie Davis. She's their shortstop. Got a ball low inside. There's a swing and a foul ball to first base side. We do not have the scoreboard camera up.
Yeah, it's too windy for that. So we decided to play it safe and do it old-fashioned way.
Yeah. So we will try to. All right, we've got two balls and one strike on Anna Cox. And there's a swing and out of play. So we've got two balls and two strikes on Anna. Ball inside, runner going to third. She is there in time. So that's number 15, Anna Cox on third. So we've got three balls and two strikes on Maddie Davis. There's a foul ball. Still three balls and two strikes. And there's a high pop fly. Catcher's coming back to get it and unable to get that. That wind is blowing pretty strong out there. It's blowing from the west, so it's gonna, you get a good high fly ball out to right side and it has a chance to go.
Yeah, I could go anywhere with this wind too. Especially my car.
Yeah. Oh, and there is a high fly ball to left center field, and it is to the fence. One run will score.
That's a double.
And that is another stand-up double. It's a double for Maddie Davis and an RBI.
So that puts SWIC on the board.
All right, up to bat for Swick is number 17, Colleen Jahnke, J-A-H-N-K-E. If I mispronounce these names, I apologize.
Yeah, I think it'd be Jahnke, too.
Jahnke?
Yeah.
We'll go with that until someone else tells us different.
Feel free to leave a comment,
yes.
Too.
Leave a comment. Let me know. Let us know.
Yeah, we have Mike Moore seeing Hattie, and good luck. Thank you, Mike.
Howdy. All right, we've got one ball and one strike on Colleen.
Here's a pitch.
And there is a to the right center field. Center fielder was tracking it and Miss that.
And another run score.
Another run scores.
That was 24 Davis with the run.
Yes.
Maddie Davis.
Maddie Davis. Colleen with a double and an RBI.
Yeah, that was A.J. Howell out there trying to catch the ball, but it slipped past her fingers.
Yes, just off the end of the glove. That's why I said that wind is going to be very tricky, especially for those high fly balls out there. Be hard to track, but that ball's going to be pushed. And there's a foul ball out of play on the right side. And there's another foul ball out of play. There is a fly ball to right field, and the right fielder has it for the catch. Runner at second tagged up and headed to third. Made it there safely. Sweet.
So that's three outs. Well, all right.
I missed an out.
Yeah. Well, we'll take a quick break here. You're listening to Mule Nation powered by RJ Marketing.
When a Fairfield fire truck needs a repair, CAM's there to keep things rolling. And as part of the volunteer fire department, Justin's looking out for Cam and all of Fairfield. Everyone supports each other, and Wayne White Electric Cooperative supports them all with safe, reliable power for every one of our members. It's why REMCs exist, and together, it all works.
All right, maybe. And welcome back. We are at the bottom of the first inning where the FCC Bobcats are getting ready to batter up here to hopefully make some runs of their own.
Yes. We're not positive on that last. We're wondering if maybe the runner had left early from second to cause that third out, because all of us up here only had two outs marked. But, yes, Swick did get two runs on the board on three base hits.
And the pitcher for the Blue Storm will be Grace Mindorf. And the catcher is number 27, Peyton Hippert. And here comes A.J. up to bat now.
Yeah, number 13, A.J. Howell.
Yeah, I can't pronounce Hallowell. Our first name, so
Hallowell.
We'll just keep it at that.
Oh, yeah, that's what he has wrote down on the thing is just A.J.
Yeah, her first name's pretty hard to pronounce.
Go with A.J.
Yeah,
simple. That's what I called her last time, too, was A.J. A.J.'s playing center field for Frontier today. First pitch is a ball. She is a lefty hitter.
Let's see if she can reach that RV out there. You ever watch Breaking Bad?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what the vibes I'm getting right now.
All right, we've got one ball and one strike on AJ. And there is a swing, a little blooper pop into right field, just over the second baseman's head. That's a perfect single.
Yeah, that was Lexi Ryan trying to catch it there for Blue Storm, but it went over. And up to bat now we have 15, Ivy Edwards.
Ivy is playing third base for Frontier. Oh, she gets a little ground ball to the second baseman.
That will advance AJ, though, to second.
Correct. So we've got a 4-3 put out on that. So up to bat now is number 9.
Carly Bean. The veteran.
The pitcher. And there is a fly ball center field,
and
that is
here.
Gone.
Tie game.
Home run for Carly. two-run home run ties the game up. Told you that ball gets up in the air out there. It's just that wind's going to carry it.
Oh, yeah. That wind helps.
Yes.
It'll either be your best friend or your worst enemy.
Exactly. And so far we found out that first half inning, that it was almost our worst enemy there. So.
Now we have Cat Ripit Hibbert up to bat. Yeah, we call her Ripit Hibbert because she can rip it.
Yes. Yeah, last Bobcats game I did was with Derek, and he was letting me know all the little nicknames for him.
Mm-hmm.
Cat is playing right field.
Derek's pretty creative.
He is. All right, yes. Number 42, Cat Hibbert, playing right field for the Bobcats today. She takes a strike inside. It's a nice little screwball.
Almost got hit in the shins there.
Well, that was a little screwball. Supposed to... It
watch yourself.
it does that right in the end. A little change up she tried to throw.
Two for one now, one out. It's a... We're tied at two, bottom of the first inning.
There's a foul ball out of play. There's that wind picking up again. But the one thing I can be, that sun is shining. And it's rained just enough, it looks like, that, the dust isn't going to fly too bad.
No. There's still some mud out there.
Yeah. Ball inside. Ball four. Cat's going to take the first base on the walk. Now we've got number 23, Abby Cunningham, up to bat. The catcher for the Bobcats. Got ball low. There is one out. There's a high fly ball, right field. Right fielder has it for the out.
And Cat will stay on first.
Cat will come back to first.
Up to bat now, we have number 11, Natty Dungy. Addie plays volleyball, and she didn't play softball last spring, but decided to play it this year.
Yes. We talked to her the last time I done was up here with in the broadcast.
She wanted to challenge herself.
She did. She did, and she did a very good job, I believe, when we were at the end of those games. She had several hits. She was on fire that last game I was here. Right now, she's got one ball and one strike. Again, there are two outs. There's a little, that's a foul ball.
1-2 the count, two outs. Runner on first. Bottom of the first inning, tied at two.
Yep, we've got, Cat still at first base.
Yes, ma'am. Pitch on the way.
Ball outside.
All right, got twos across the board now.
All across the board.
All across, yes. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Tied at two. Pitch on the way.
Oh.
That's a strikeout. So we'll be right back. We're tied at 2-2 going in the top of the second inning. You're watching Mule Nation powered by RJ Marketing.
No time to run to the bank? No problem. People's National Bank makes banking easy and convenient with PNB To Go mobile banking. PNB To Go allows you to deposit checks, pay bills, transfer money between accounts, view your statements, turn your debit card off and on, and much more, all on your smartphone. It truly is banking at your fingertips with PNB To Go mobile banking. People's National Bank, member FDIC.
All right, and welcome back here to Southwest Park, where we are tied at 2-2, the top of the second inning, where the Blue Storm are looking to get their lead back with some runs.
Yeah, first up to bat for the Blue Storm will be number 5, Lexi Ryan. On deck is 19, Taylen Smith. We're in the top of the second inning. Got strike one on Lexi. Carly's feeling pretty good about herself right now. Strike two after that two-run home run in that last inning she had. And three straight strikes on Lexi for a strikeout. That's the second strikeout that Carly's given today. Now we've got 19, Taylen Smith up to bat. Ball one. There's a strike on that outside corner. Nice curveball. Got one ball and one strike. We got ball low. And you can just hear that wind a howling. Got strike two looking. Two balls, two strikes on Taylen. Ball high. Three balls, two strikes, full count. Bases are clear. I know it's kind of hard to see. We tried to adjust the camera as good as we could to get the actual first and second base. And that's a swinging strike three.
Good pitching here by Bean.
Yes, Bean is on fire so far today. All right, up to bat for Swick is number 27, Peyton Lilpert. Lilpert, L-I-L-P-E-R-T.
I would say Lilpert.
Lilpert, yeah. Again, we apologize if we mispronounce. So, Peyton has two strikes. And the pitch. And then swinging strike three. Three up, three down. And we will go to the bottom of the second inning.
You're watching Mule Nation, powered by RJ Martin.
Are you a small business owner? Say goodbye to bookkeeping headaches. At F&B Financial Tax and Consulting, our top-notch accounting services will keep your finances in order, allowing you to focus on what you do best, growing your business. With F&B Financial, you're not just a client, you're family. Contact us at 618-842-2183 or visit us online at fnbcommunitybank.com. Experience peace of mind with our expert support.
And welcome back here to Southwest Park at the Bobcat Softball Field, where we are at the bottom of the second inning, where we are tied at 2-2.
Yeah, and we've got Riley Cunningham.
All right, we have Mike Moore saying go Carly, indeed, and Crystal Murray saying hello. I'm AJ13 mom. Let's go Bobcats. Well,
hey,
thank you for watching.
Hi, AJ's mom.
Mama Crystal.
Mama Crystal. I'll just call you Mama Crystal. Yeah, keep those comments coming, making sure that you can still hear us.
Up to bat now, we have Riley Cunningham.
Yep. She's our shortstop for the Bobcats. And wears the number 32. Bobcats are wearing their yellow.
Her sister's
jerseys.
Number's backwards. It's 23.
23, yep. Ball one on Riley. We've got the girls cheering there. There's a swing foul.
Getting some excitement in the dugout.
I know. I like to hear that.
Mm-hmm.
It's important, in, especially in this sport, that you know
you've
got your...
Spark some life.
Yes. Oh, and there's a little liner to shortstop. She catches that for the out.
Yeah, that was 24, Maddie Davis, the shortstop for SWIC.
All right, now up to bat is number 7. Kaylee Halsema.
Yeah, I believe it's pronounced Halsema.
Yep.
So that's the ball one for Halsema.
Halsema.
One out.
Oh, and there's a little dribbler to the pitcher to first for out number 2. It's a 1-3 put out. All right, here, now to bat.
Hadley Jarborough.
Okay, we got 00. Ryland Jarborough up to bat. Oh, there's a swing foul, right side.
Whenever you see double zeros, it's not good.
Why not?
They're always good. Pitch on the way.
Got ball low. Got one ball, one strike. Let's hope. Let's get a two-out rally going on right now. Get Rye on base. And strike number 2.
1-2 the count, 2 outs.
It's a nice curveball.
Still tied at 2 apiece.
Got ball outside. Just try to throw that again. See if she'd chase. She didn't take that. Got 2s across the board again.
All over.
Mm-hmm. And the pitch. Got ball 3. 3 balls, 2 strikes. We've got a full count on Rye. Pitch. And there's a hard hit right up the middle.
For a single. And here comes AJ up to bat again.
Yep. We're back to the top of the lineup. Number 13, AJ Hallowell. Last up to bat. She got a single. This little blooper went over the second baseman's head. We'll take that again. Get Rye moved over to second, third, somewhere in that area. So strike 1 on AJ. And there's a nice hard hit down the first baseline, scooped up by their first baseman for the unassisted out.
So that'll do it for the bottom of the second inning. 0-0 for that inning, and it's still tied 2-2. We'll take a quick break. You're watching Mule Nation, powered by RJ Marketing.
Collect wax flowers and gifts in downtown Fairfield. Make someone smile with some flower therapy. Whether they deserve a high five or need to feel better, a beautiful, fresh floral arrangement from Blax will fit the bill. Also, check out Blax for that perfect gift. They carry home decor, locally made jewelry, soaps and candles, candy and snack baskets, and balloon bouquets. For flower therapy or gifts for any occasion, see Blax Flowers and Gifts at 310 East Main in Fairfield or call 618-847-7076.
And welcome back here to Southwest Park, where it's going to be Carly Bean pitching again. She had a tremendous inning, that last inning, pitching.
Yes, she did.
And up to bat for the Blue Storm, we have number 3, J.C. Elliott. We are still tied at 2-2. Pitch on the way.
Ball in. Pitch on the way. There's a strike on the inside. Got one ball and one strike. There's a hit to short to the first base and out. Nice 6-3 for the put out. It's Riley Cunningham.
Abby's the catcher.
Yep. Strike one on number 12, Emily Rupert. Swicks backed up to their top of their lineup. Ball outside.
One ball, one strike, one out. 2-2 tied.
And there is a little slapper hit to the center field. It will drop. And AJ will get that in.
That'll be a single. And up to bat now, we have number 15, Ender Cox, for the Blue Storm.
Anna is their DP for today. She wears the number 15 for Swick, and they're
fouled.
Oh, almost. It's a good hustle there by Kaylee. So that's one strike on Anna. And the pitch, and there's another foul ball out of play. Carly steps on the mound.
0-2 the count.
Oh, nice hard hit. Oh, right up the middle, just past shortstop. We've got Emily rounding to third.
So we got runners on the corners.
And then that will be, so that was a hard hit up the, up the middle. So that's a single for Anna. So we've got runners at first and third, and there's only one out.
Up and to bat, we have 24, Maddie Davis. Pitch on the way.
It's going to hold the runners. And get her to possible hit into a double play, get out of this pickle they got in. And there's a swing and a miss. Last time up to bat, Maddie Davis hit a RBI double. And the pitch. And ball inside. She's going to second. Ball is thrown into the center field. One run will score. Throw to third. And she is in safely. That was not... believe they were trying to pick that runner off at third with a little sneak play, but the ball went right over the shortstop's glove, Riley's glove, and went right into center field. So that allowed one run to score. So up to bat still is Maddie Davis. She's got a one ball, two strike count. Now we've got a two ball, two strike count.
3-2 score.
Oh, called strike three. It's a nice little screwball she threw on Maddie. So we've got two outs. And there's number 17, Colleen Jonke. She's playing third base today. Last up to bat, she had a RBI double. She takes strike one. And there is a hit straight up. Kaylee's trying, and it's out of play.
Up to the count.
And the pitch. Ball low.
1-2.
Got one ball and two strikes. There are two outs. So far, Carly's got five strikeouts on the game. We are in the top of the third inning. The score is 3-2. Favor Swick, and there is a high fly ball left field. Will fall in between. That will score another run, so there is an RBI single for Colleen.
So it's a 4-2 ball game now. Blue Storm leads it. Two outs.
Up to bat now is number 28, and there's a foul out of play. Got Maggie Grauman. Up to bat. Last up to bat, she had that fly ball to right field, which was caught. All right, we've got a two ball, one strike count. We do have two outs. Colleen, number 17, is on first base.
4-2, Blue Storm leads it.
And the pitch. And there's a swing right over. Oh, foul ball. Just barely.
It was right there.
Went right over the third baseman's head. You couldn't see it for the camera. It's because it being so windy, we're unable to get the entire field. But it just missed that foul line. And there's another high fly ball. Center is coming in for the catch, and she has it. Good job, AJ, for out number three. And that will end the inning. And the Bobcats will come up to bat. But Swick scores two, and the score is 4-2.
So you're watching Mule Nation, powered by RJ Marketing.
When a Fairfield fire truck needs a repair, CAM's there to keep things rolling. And as part of the volunteer fire department, Justin's looking out for CAM and all of Fairfield. Everyone supports each other, and Wainwright Electric Cooperative supports them all with safe, reliable power for every one of our members. It's why REMCs exist, and together, It all works.
And welcome back here to Southwest Park. It's the bottom of the third inning where the Blue Storm leads the Bobcats 4-2. Up to bat now for the Bobcats, we have 15, Ivy Edwards. Pitcher for the Blue Storm is Grace Middendorf. And the catcher is 27, Peyton Hilpert. Pitch on the way. Ball one. Swing and a miss. 1-1 the count.
Got her to chase that one. Reaching outside. That did have a nice little curve to it.
Mm-hmm.
And there's another one. Foul ball to the right side. So we've got a 1-ball, 2-strike count.
Pitch on the way.
Ball high. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Oh, that's close.
Full count
she
now.
She held her bat back
instead
of going after that. So we've got a 3-ball, 2-strike count. Nope, she did not go. Okay. Pitch on the way. Ball four. She's going to take a walk. Walk on down to first base.
And here comes the pitcher now, number 9, Carly Bean, up to bat.
Let's see if they give her anything to hit this time. I mean, if I'm Swick, I just make sure I don't pitch that same pitch again to her. There's strike one. Just don't give her anything fat, but Carly's just going to be looking for something that is good and hittable. But they're going to pitch all around her. Off-speed pitch. Try to get her on that changeup.
1-1 to count for Bean.
And the pitch. And there's a popper in the infield. Second baseman has it. Jammed her on the inside.
That was 5, Lexi Ryan with the catch. Now we have Kat Rippet Hibbett, number 42, up to bat. One out, 4-2. SWIC leads it.
Got ball inside. Last up to bat, Kat walked. Right, we still have Ivy Edwards on first base. She's getting a pretty good jump out there. And the pitch, and then jammed her inside. Way to fight that off.
So
she's been hitting that inside corner real well.
2-1 the count now for Hibbett. One out. Runner on first.
Another inside pitch. Yep.
2-2 the count.
Just trying to jam her and get her to do the same thing that Carly just did and pop that up. Jam it and pop it up, but foul ball stayed alive there. Just needs to find that gap. Looks like to me it's that gap on that right center field there. area or right over third baseman's head. It's kind of like a little land and got her on that off speed high pitch. For a strikeout.
That'll be out number two for this inning.
Now we got Abby Cunningham up to bat, number 23, your catcher.
That's a ball for Cunningham.
Strike one. There's two outs on the board. Got a 1-1 count. Strike two.
One, two, the count, two outs. Runner on first.
Grace is really good at hitting that inside corner. Last up to bat, Abby had a fly ball to right, and there is a nice job. Ivy Edwards stole second base, catcher threw, and the ball just flew right up over the shortstop's glove and into center field. So Ivy is in there safely at second. Puts a runner in scoring position. We've got two balls, two strikes, and there is a high fly ball to the fence that will score one.
And make that a double for Cunningham.
And that's a double for Abby Cunningham. Good job, RBI double.
So now the Bobcats trail by one, 4-3. The bottom of the third inning.
All right, now we've got number 11, Addie Dungy, up to bat. She is the left fielder. She takes ball high. A lot can happen with two outs. It's that two out rally. And there is a nice hit in the middle.
Caught.
The second baseman's got it just right at the grass.
That'll be at number three. So that'll do it for the bottom of the third inning. We go to the top of the fourth inning. The Bobcats trail by one, 4-3. You're watching Mule Nation, powered by RJ Marketing.
No time to run to the bank? No problem. People's National Bank makes banking easy and convenient with PNB To Go mobile banking. PNB To Go allows you to deposit checks, pay bills, transfer money between accounts, view your statements, turn your debit card off and on, and much more, all on your smartphone. It truly is banking at your fingertips with PNB To Go mobile banking. People's National Bank, member FDIC.
All right, and welcome back here to Southwest Park at the Bobcat softball field, where they trail the Southwestern College by one run, 4-3, at the top of the fourth inning. It'll still be Carly Bean pitching.
Yeah, last inning. Frontier had, well, we just had that one hit, but we did score one run, so we are now back up closer again. Score is 4-3. Up to bat for Swick will be number five, Lexi Ryan. And then Taylan Smith. And then Peyton Lila Pert. So, I'm waiting on Abby Cunningham, catcher, because she was the last batter. Get her stuff on. She throws down to second in the warm-up throw. All right. Last time up to bat, Riley. Number five, Lexi, sorry. Struck out looking. And there, she's got a hit to center field up high in the air. Oh, AJ just about lost that one. That wind picked up just in the wrong time, but she has the catch for the out. That's one out for Now we've got number 19, Taylan Smith, up to bat. She's playing left field. And there's a hit, foul ball out of play. Ball inside.
1-1 the count, one out. Bean with a pitch.
And there's a nice liner to second base.
Two easy outs.
Little Rye out there at second. So that's a lineup. Up to bat for Swick is Peyton, number 27. She takes strike one. That wind is still blowing pretty good out there. There's a swing and a miss for strike two.
And it's a big factor on where that ball lands, too.
Yep. It's been a big factor so far today with those balls hitting the outfield. See how that ball just curved right. Oh, just under AJ's glove. Hits the ground for a single.
Up to bat now we have JC Elliott, number 3.
All right, looks like we're getting ready to have a, we're going to have a courtesy runner for Peyton. Peyton is their catcher. Looks like we're going to have number 8. Number 8, Carly Fower Sterling, will be running for Peyton. In a courtesy runner. She'll be the courtesy runner. And there's a hit to right in between short and third out to the left field grass.
That'll be a single.
That'll be, yep. Another single for Swick.
Up to bat now we have number 12, Emily Rupert.
Last up to bat, Emily had a single right up the middle.
That's a foul.
And she has struck out. There are still two outs in the top of this fourth inning. Got a ball low. So one ball, one strike.
We got runners on second and first for SWIC.
Nice ball up.
2-1 the count.
Now we have Carly on first. And we have Peyton at second and JC at first.
And that'll be an out at first. So that'll do it for the top of the fourth inning. SWIC still leads at 4-3. You're watching Mule Nation, powered by RJ Marketing.
Are you a small business owner? Say goodbye to bookkeeping headaches. At F&B Financial Tax and Consulting, our top-notch accounting services will keep your finances in order, allowing you to focus on what you do best, growing your business. With F&B Financial, you're not just a client, you're family. Contact us at 618-842-2183 or visit us online at fnbcommunitybank.com. Experience peace of mind with our expert support.
And welcome back here to Southwest Park, where the Bobcats trail by one run, 4-3 at the bottom of the fourth inning.
Yeah, that last inning up to bats, Swick only had... We had one hit, two hits. No runs were scored on that. We have Grace number 20, still pitching for Swick.
And this is Riley Cunningham up to bat.
Number 32. Shortstop, she hits a little ground ball to first base. First baseman will take it with ease, and the out. For out number one. Now we've got number 7. Kay Holsema up to bat. She takes strike one. Last up to bat, she hit into a ground ball to the pitcher. Right, went right back to the pitcher. She laid off that one. That was nice. Way to lay off that. That looked pretty coming in, but she took some speed off of that pitch.
1-1 the count. One out.
Ball outside. Now two balls, one strike. She checked.
Two to the count.
Stopped her swing for strike two. And the pitch, a ball inside. Try to throw that screwball again.
Full count now for Halsema.
And there is a ground ball to the short, to first for the out. We're a 6-3 out for out number 2 on the Bobcats. We've got number, double zeros up to bat. Rylan. Rylan Jarbo up to bat. Last up to bat, she had a single right up the middle. She takes ball one. Get another two-out rally going. Last inning that she had two outs and she was up to bat, she had started the two-out rally.
And we've seen a lot of them thus far.
She takes ball number 3. She's got a 3-0 count. Grace comes to the, takes strike one, 3-1, one strike. There are two outs. Score is 4-3 in favor of Swick. And she takes ball 4. She's going to head down to first base on the walk. And that brings up number 13, AJ Hollowell. Her last up to bat, she had a little ground ball to first base. And she singled. Got ball high. Get to listen to the girls cheer it on, get them going. Mm-hmm. Oh, there's this. Look, and she is out. Out at second on the steal. Rylan tried to take off, and AJ was showing that bunt. So AJ will come up to bat in the next inning. Bobcats score none.
So we're going to the top of the fifth inning. SWIC leads at 4-3. You're watching Mule Nation, powered by RJ Marketing.
It's a beautiful day in Fairfield, isn't it? Introducing a new weekly podcast on Friday mornings at 8:30 a.m. on YouTube. It's a beautiful day in Fairfield, featuring local events and news, special guests, birthdays, anniversaries, trivia, and more. Follow us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel at RJ on the Air.
All right, and welcome back here to the Southwest Park. It's the top of the fifth inning now. Frontier trails 4-3 against Southwestern College.
Yeah, and we will have number 15, Anna Cox, up to bat. Last time up to bat, she had a single to the left center field, and she had a double in the first inning. She is their designated player for today, and then there's another high fly ball to center field. Jay's back and has it for the catch at the warning track for out number one. Whew. That looked really close. She caught that right there in the middle of that track. Just didn't get enough on it, but that's okay. All right, up to bat is number 24, Maddie Davis, shortstop for Swick. Yeah, ball high. There's a swing, strike one.
And there's that wind.
There's that wind. Picking up again. That's what you hear blowing out there. The sun is shining, though. Oh, foul tip. So we have one ball, two strikes. There is one out. But, yeah, it's still a beautiful day for softball.
Mm-hmm.
Baseball plays tonight, I do believe, now. There's a check swing for a strike.
One to the count. Pitch on the way.
Oh, that had some awesome movement on it. Looked like a little curvy rise ball that happened for swinging strike three on Davis for out number two. We've got number 17, Colleen Jonkey, up to bat.
Bobcats just need one more out.
Got ball up. There's two balls and no strikes. Last time up to bat, Colleen had an RBI single. A strike one on Colleen.
Two on the count.
First time up to bat, Colleen had a RBI double. A strike two, hit that outside corner. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. And there's a hit to right field, right over her head, hits the fence, the bottom of the fence, but Cat keeps her at a single.
That was AJ Howell that tried to catch it, but
AJ
slipped past her.
I have.
Oh, no, that's not AJ.
That's Kat.
Yeah, that's Kat.
I was going to say, Kat's playing right. AJ's playing center.
Yes, my bad.
That's okay. I was like, am I looking at Ryan? And then, oh, good try, diving cat, or a dive for Addie and the run home. And they have her for
out.
The out at home. That was a nice relay. She was not out. That is correct. She was over here. She was not in the baseline. She was not out in front of the plate.
And the coach isn't happy what and he sees.
No, he is not. She was not standing right there. But here we go. But anyway, what had happened was there was a cat or a high fly ball to line drive, sorry, to left field. And the center fielder, AJ, gets it in. They relay it in to the catcher, and they get Colleen out at home.
All right, so we'll take a quick break. Bobcats trail 4-3. You're watching Mule Nation powered by RG Marketing.
Collect wax flowers and gifts in downtown Fairfield. Make someone smile with some flower therapy. Whether they deserve a high five or need to feel better, a beautiful fresh floral arrangement from Blax will fit the bill. Also, check out Blax for that perfect gift. They carry home decor, locally made jewelry, soaps and candles, candy and snack baskets, and balloon bouquets. For flower therapy or gifts for any occasion, see Blax Flowers and Gifts at 310 East Main in Fairfield or call 618-847-7076.
All right, and welcome back here to Southwest Park. It's the bottom of the fifth inning now. A.J. Howell is up to bat now. Pitch on the way. That's a strike.
It's a strike on that outside corner. AJ was up to bat that last inning when Rylan was attempted to steal second and was called off. Oh, that was a nice snag by the second baseman, and they throw her out at first for a 4-3. Out number one.
Ivy Edwards up to bat now.
She takes ball outside.
Pitch on the way. Ball. Two balls, no strikes, one out. 4-3, SWIC leads it. Bottom of the fifth inning.
Yeah, we're at the bottom of the fifth. Frontier's up to bat, and there's a foul ball out of play. Last time up to bat, Ivy had a walk, which she ended up scoring. Oh, there's a high ball.
3-1 the count now for Edwards.
She takes ball four. She's going to take her trot down first base. That's her second walk in a row. Which brings up number 9, Carly Bean, our pitcher for today. Last up to bat, they jammed her on the inside and popped up to second base. And first inning, she had a 2-run home run. We've got one ball and one strike on Carly. She's got a ball in the dirt.
2-1 the count now. Runner on first. One out. 4-3 ball game.
We are still in the bottom of the fifth inning. Oh, there's a nice hit right up the middle to center field. Oh, and she's going to get.
She's out. Nope.
No. They called her safe.
They called her safe.
Because she was bobbling the ball on the catch. It popped out of her glove and went to the other hand. Swick coach is arguing the call, but as...
And it was that same player, too.
Yeah. And as Ivy was coming into third base on the slide, the third baseman had the ball in her glove, and then she went to go tag her, and then it... So just have some little arguing issues going on. Basically just saying that she did not have control of the ball on the tag. So now Frontier has runners at first and second, because that will be a single on for Carly. Give her a single, and then she advanced to second on that throw to third. And then there's a high fly ball to center, right center field.
Caught.
Right fielder has it. She's going to tag up, and she scores. So that will tie up the game. Ivy came in. So that was a nice sacrifice fly for Cat.
So we are tied at 4-4.
And then honestly, I think.
Pitch on the way. This is Abby Cunningham, number 23, up to bat now. We have Bean on third. Two outs. Tied at four. All right, pitch on the way. It's going to be a ground ball for a single. Bean will score.
Yes, all the right. Score is 4 for Swick and 5 for us. We'll have to adjust the scoreboard after this inning. It happens. It's okay. Oh, there's a hit to third, to first.
Out.
So
it's a 5-4. Frontier leads it. To the top of the sixth inning we go. You're watching Mule Nation, powered by RJ Marketing.
When a Fairfield fire truck needs a repair, CAM's there to keep things rolling. And as part of the volunteer fire department, Justin's looking out for CAM and all of Fairfield. Everyone supports each other, and Wainwright Electric Cooperative supports them all with safe, reliable power for every one of our members. It's why REMCs exist, and together, it all works.
And welcome back here to Southwest Park at Bobcat Softball Field, where they lead it 5-4 at the top of the sixth inning. And the Swig coach is still exchanging words with the umpire.
Yeah, he's still not happy. I mean, I could see where he's coming from, thinking, you know, that. You know, that it was, you know, a transfer kind of thing. He said that she had control, which it is just a, you know, I've been there, done that. I've umpired many games, and it's one of those calls that
you can't just satisfy with, everyone.
You know, no, you can't. You can't. I mean, and mind you, like from here, it looked as if, you know, she went, she tagged, and the ball came out of her glove, but with the other hand for the actual tag. I mean, it was like a pretty, I call it a botched up play that, you know, just depends on what angle you saw and when you saw it. So, but as an umpire, you stick with that call.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you stick with what you say. You don't overturn it just to satisfy, you know, you stick with your call. So the score is, yes, the score, the coach is now asking what the score is. It is,
yeah, I don't know how to check out back off the board.
Yeah,
I'm a rookie.
Yes, not for sure how to. Last time I think D was up here doing it, she had to, like, turn the whole thing off and then start it all over. But
so it's Lexi Ryan, number 5, up to bat for the Blue Storm.
She takes strike one.
And if they do score one run in this inning, you don't have to worry about changing it.
It's on the wrong one.
Yeah.
Just drawing the wrong inning, but it's okay. I mean, it happens. I mean, if they've got my opinion, there's more things to worry about than, you know, as long as they've got their score books right down there, that's pretty well what matters right now. There's a strike, so we have two balls and two strikes. I've watched Swick play, you know, quite a while. My oldest played for Kaskaskia, so she played against them several times. Oh, you just put strike three. Yes, it is 2-2. It's okay. I know.
2-2 the count.
You just can't. That's the thing with this scoreboard. I don't think there's a swing and a miss for a strike three for one out number one. No, go ahead.
All right, up to bat now.
I've got it wrote down.
We have number 19, Taylan Smith.
I've got it wrote down. Yeah. Okay. Got Jeremy up here doing the scoreboard. There's a swing and a miss on Taylan.
We have Mike Cunningham commenting, "Let's go Bobcats."
Hi, Mike.
Let us know where you're watching from.
I wonder if he's part of the Abby and Riley Cunningham crew.
Probably so.
I'm going to say so. Thanks for watching, listening.
Pitch on the way. Swing and miss.
There's a swing and a miss. Strike two, or strike out number two for Carly.
Number 27 up to net bat now is Peyton Hilpert for SWIC.
It's Lipert. Lilipert. I think it's like L-I-L-P-E-R-T. Lilipert? I don't know.
Swing and miss.
We'll just call her Peyton. Hi, Peyton. And the pitch. We got ball high. It's for one ball and one strike. Oh, timeout. Had to tie her shoes. Rylan out there tying her shoes. Oh.
2-1 the count. Two outs, no runners. It's a 5-4 Bobcats lead.
Got ball three. Three balls, one strikes, two outs. We will have a game two after this one. That there's a strike two. So we have a three ball, two strike count on the batter. And two outs. The pitch. And there is a high fly ball in the infield. Carly's called it and has it for out number three. That's three outs for Bobcats will come up to bat.
So we're Bobcats lead at 5-4 going into the sixth inning. You're watching Mule Nation powered by RJ Marketing.
It's a beautiful day in Fairfield, isn't it? Introducing a new weekly podcast on Friday mornings at 8:30 a.m. on YouTube. It's a beautiful day in Fairfield. Featuring local events and news, special guests, birthdays, anniversaries, trivia, and more. Follow us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel at RJ On The Air.
And welcome back. It's the bottom of the sixth inning where the Bobcats lead the Blue Storm by one run, 5-4. All right, up to bat we have Riley Cunningham, 32.
Yes. Her guest is 2.
Pitch on the way. Ball.
Mm-hmm. Got ball low. Fourth inning, yeah. Yep. And then fifth inning, zero.
2-1 the count for Cunningham.
Yes, 5-4. And then now, then the top of the sixth will put zeros for Guest.
And that'll be out number one. Up to bat now for the Bobcats, we have Kaylee Hausema, number 7. And we have one out already. Pitch on the way. Foul ball.
All right. Back now. We've got the scoreboard fixed for them. All right. So what did Riley do that first?
She got out first.
How'd she do that?
She hit the ball and they threw it to first. I think it was the shortstop that.
Oh, it went from shortstop. Yeah. So had a little grounder to first.
Mm-hmm.
Or to shortstop to first. All right. So we've got Kaylee up to bat.
And that'll be a strikeout. Oh. Out number 2.
Looking. All right, Rylan up the bat. The second baseman. Hey, she gets our two-out rally started every time she's up, so maybe we can get that two-out rally going again. She takes strike. 2.
Oh, 2 the count, 2 outs, 5-4, Bobcats lead.
Wind picks up again. She takes ball out. Man, that's a good, strong gust of wind. That flagpole out there is just a.
Yeah, it's blowing.
Blowing like crazy.
1-2 the count for Jarbo. Pitch on the way.
Oh, there's a little butt to first. She misses, drops the ball, and she is safe.
She didn't quite get control on that, the SWIC player.
Yeah, she had it and then lost it. Did not realize she lost that ball till she went to go tag, and it wasn't there. All right, we've got AJ up to bat. Last up to bat, she hit to second base.
That's a strike. Pitch on the way.
She takes ball high. Yeah, the Bobcat baseball game has been scheduled for 5 o'clock. Oh, she's going to – there she goes. Now she'll make it. Rylan steals second base.
It was close.
She got a really good jump on that.
Surprised the Schwick coach didn't call me about that one.
I know. Well, probably, yeah.
Give it a minute.
Yeah, I was going to say. And then. Oh, and there is a. And it's dropping left field.
And Jarvel's going to go Ryan's all the way.
He's going to come in for nice RBI.
So it's a 6-4 Bobcat lead.
It is. So AJ's on second base at the moment. We have 2 outs. See, told you there was going to be that 2-out rally. But as I was saying before, we have the Bobcat Nation baseball. They will be playing. It's been was rescheduled, and they'll now be played at 5 o'clock today. Just so they.
So we're going to have a little break until then.
Well, for the baseball boys, yeah. They'll be playing at 5. All right, we've got 1 ball and 1 strike. and Ivy. Last up to bat, actually last two up to bats, Ivy has walked. Oh, AJ's gonna, she steals third.
She's safe.
Nice jump, caught them off guard. So a stolen base for AJ. Ivy, she is, got a one ball, two strike count. There are two outs. AJ is at third. Like I said, last two up to bats, Ivy has walked and scored both times.
So for Ivy Edwards, it's one ball, two strikes, two outs, runner on third.
There is a hot shot to first base. She's got that for the out, for an unassisted first base for out number three. But Frontier Bobcats get one more on the board, and it is 6-4 Bobcats.
So we're going to the top of the seventh inning. You're listening to Mule Nation powered by RJ Marketing.
Are you a small business owner? Say goodbye to bookkeeping headaches. At FNB Financial Tax and Consulting, our top-notch accounting services will keep your finances in order, allowing you to focus on what you do best, growing your business. With FNB Financial, you're not just a client, you're family. Contact us at 618-842-2183 or visit us online at fnbcommunitybank.com. Experience peace of mind with our expert support.
And welcome back here to Southwest Park at the top of the seventh inning, where the Bobcats lead it 6-4. Bean will still be pitching, and Cunningham will still be catching.
Yeah, so far Bean has been doing an amazing job out there on that mound. And at the plate, she's been doing a great job. All right, if we can hold them here, then...
It's ball game.
It's ball game. But still got three outs to go. And there is a foul ball and out of play. It's J.C. Elliott up to bat.
Strike one.
Southwestern Illinois College.
Crystal Murray's watching from Princeton, Kentucky.
Hi, Crystal. Thank you for watching.
We appreciate all our viewers.
We do.
Pitch on the way. Swing
There's
and miss.
There's a swing and miss. Strike three.
And that's what you want to see.
Yes, it is. Yeah, Carly's, you know, knock on wood because, you know, it's not over till it's over, but...
Ain't over till the fat lady sings.
and then she throws that one a little wide and out and up, and she's laughing that one off, though, and that's good to see for a pitcher, especially, you know, just you know that she's having a good time out there. She's good and relaxed, and those little pitches that will happen, she just laughs it off.
Yeah.
All right, so we've got one ball, one strike.
Number 12, Emily Rupert. She has one ball, one strike. Yep, as the third, and one out.
She's the top of the lineup, playing center field.
1-2 the count.
Let's see, her last up to bat. Grounded out. She has had a single in this game and scored a run. There's a ball outside.
2-2 the count. Pitch on the way.
Oh, there is a foul ball. She reached for that one. Just trying to stay alive there.
If you're the Blue Storm, you got to.
Yep. You gotta keep fighting. I mean, both sides, you got to keep fighting. You just can't give up, you know. It's kind of like that saying, you know, it's not over till the fat lady sings, mm-hmm. And, you know. There's a strike three looking. She hit the outside corner on that ball. Had some amazing movement on it.
Up to bat now is 15. That is Anna Cox. Bobcats just need one more out. They lead it 6-4.
Still a lot of things can happen on two outs.
Mm-hmm.
Which last up to bat, Anna hit a fly ball to center field.
Strike one.
She has had a single. Actually, she's had a single and a double in this ball game so far. She takes ball low.
2-2 the count. No, 1-1 the count.
1-1. Hear the wind howling. She takes ball low.
2-1. Two outs.
I mean, I will say, you know, we've got the little booth up here and stuff. It is small, but it is protecting us, keeping us from that wind out there. Well, she takes ball three. Carly just needs to take a deep breath and just throw.
Relax.
Yeah, just relax and throw. And there's the pitch. And there it is. Oh, right back at her, but up the middle. I mean, no harm, no foul right now. So that is a single for Anna.
Maddie Davis, 24, is coming up to bat now.
Last two up to bats, Maddie has struck out. But the first inning, she did have a RBI double.
Pitch on the way.
There's a strike. Nice pitch on that inside. We have ball low.
1-1.
Carly comes to the mound, and the pitch. Oh, that one kind of got a little away from her.
Runner will advance to second.
On that pass ball. And again, it's always like, even though there's two outs, Abby, that's the right move. Just call time, go out there, talk to your pitcher, let her know that everything's good, defense behind her, just throw, you know, do what you can do. I said it's easier said than done.
Mm-hmm.
I had one that pitched all through college also, and it is easier said than done, but your catcher is like your
best friend.
Yes, your best friend. She sees and knows and all that, and it's usually the main one that can get you calm down and just relax and just throw. Have fun out there. You know, have fun. Oh, just missed. That was a beautiful. Just missed that inside. So we have three balls and one strike. There is two outs and a runner at second base, which is Anna Cox for Swick. Oh, she gets a good jump, and Maddie will take the walk to first base. So now we have runners at first and second. Maybe Carly just wanted to make things a little interesting here for everyone. Oh, there's a strike. Oh, we got Colleen, number 17, Jonkey up to bat. Oh, just missed. It's a nice pitch. Just missed the outside. But Colleen has. There's a hit to short. No one's at third for the thing. Scoop and catch.
Out.
For the out, number three. All right, no runs. And that's ball game. Bobcats will win this game 6-4. And
we are going to take a quick break. But we'll be right back with you in game number two.
Yeah, so probably about 15, 20 minutes or so, something like that.
So the final of this game, 6-4, Frontier beats Southwestern College. To game number two we go. We'll talk to you later.
Bye.
Thank you for watching.
Be back.
Mules Baseball is brought to you by...